Thank you. Hello, ma'am. Can we start?
Start.
Okay. Good evening, everyone. I, Mrs. Shaila Shetty, would like to welcome you all and the guest speaker for the day, Mrs. Nikita Ganatra, on behalf of Bansanga Aarti Shashikaran Shetty Junior College. Thank you for joining us. In this webinar, we will learn about the importance of a foreign language. Language impacts the daily lives of members of any race, creed, and region of the world. Language helps to express our feelings, desires, and queries to the world around us. Words, gestures, and tones are utilized in union to portray a broad spectrum of emotion. The unique and devised method human being can use to communicate through written and spoken language is a large part of what allows to harness our innate ability to form lasting bonds with one another, separating mankind from the rest of the animal kingdom. Lastly, I would like to quote, knowing of knowledge is a doorway to wisdom. Thank you. Over to Juhi ma'am.
Good evening, everyone. It's a great pleasure for me to introduce our guest speaker of the day, Mrs. Nikita Amir Ganatra, ma'am. She is Bachelor in Commerce, Major in Accounting and Economics from Mumbai University. Her 19 years working experiences include, she worked as career counselor with St. Angelo's and NIIT. Being an IRDA certified, she worked in banking sector with HSBC as a senior call verification officer and HDFC as a deputy manager. Besides this, she has pursued early childcare education and worked with Ryan International School and Lodha World School. She believes that the beautiful things about learning is that nobody can take it away from you, and so go on exploring and learning new things. Along with these working experiences, she is calligraphy expert, a freelancer career counselor expert, which is done with the help of fingerprint analysis, a freelancer French translator, and as well as a French tutor. Besides this, she is a music lover and has a keen interest in sports also. Recently, she started her practice as an athlete, that is for shot put game. And last year she won state level championship and also participated for Masters National Championship. Finally, she quotes, when you believe in yourself, miracle happens. We welcome you, Nikita ma'am, and kindly invite you to speak for the occasion. Over to Nikita ma'am.
Nikita ma'am,
unmute yourself.
Nikita ma'am, unmute yourself.
Unmute yourself.
Am I audible now?
Yes.
Thank you. Bonjour. Good evening to one and all. And I'm starting with this session. Would like to thank Bansanga's Aarti Shashikiran Shetty Junior College for giving me opportunity to express my views on national level webinar. Thank you, management, principal, vice principal, all technical and non-technical staff for overall support to conduct this webinar. Dear viewers, I am sure you would like to be a good speaker, and that is possible only if you are a good listener. So let's start with the session. The session will include importance of learning foreign language and tricks for fast learning. Let's go with the next slide. Here I have included hola. Hola means hello in Spanish. What is the importance of learning foreign language? It will increase your English vocabulary. Your English vocabulary skill increases. A person becomes a multitasker, ease at facing the competitive world, beneficial for higher studies. If somebody has made up their mind and if you wish to go out of India, then definitely learning a foreign language will be a plus point. May I know the other answer, ma'am? Please go ahead. Yeah, bilingual people always are in demand. What do you mean by bilingual people? A person who speaks more than one language are known as bilingual people. You'll get a benefit of wide work scope. Like if you are learning a foreign language, then you can be an interpreter, you can work as a translator, you can work as a teacher, you can also work in multinational corporates. Apart from that, you can also broaden up your thinking process. Like you will be able to know and respect their culture, living patterns, communication style. Let's go with the other slide. Viewers, you can also learn the foreign languages. Other foreign languages are Spanish, French, Japanese, Italian, Mandarin. Mandarin means Chinese language. Portuguese, Arabic, and many more. Korean is also one of the foreign languages, and there are many other languages which you can go through. You can learn these many foreign languages. Okay, now we all know that there are much benefits of learning of foreign languages as a personal career oriented. If the people are career oriented for personal growth, learning a foreign language is beneficial. But I'm sure you will be surprised to know that there are also health benefits. So we'll go through that one by one. Surprising health benefits of learning of foreign languages are: a person can have a better decision-making skills, improved memory, it enhances your memory, increased attention span. Attention span means the amount of concentrated time a person spends on a task without getting distracted. Means the amount you get distraction decreases. So accordingly, your attention span increases. Improved ability to multitask. A person becomes a multitasker. Increased perpetual sensitivity. What do you mean by perpetual? Perpetual means forever, everlasting. So your sensitivity also increases. Better cognitive abilities. Cognitive means mental abilities, mental capabilities of a person. So while learning a foreign language, even your cognitive abilities also gets better and better. Improves your first language, that is your English vocabulary also enhances. And yes, definitely a health benefit of learning a foreign language is that about your bigger brain. What is now bigger brain? Bigger brain relates to a brain size and intelligence. People who have larger brains tends to have slightly higher IQ than those of smaller brain. So this all are the benefits you can get health benefits of by learning a foreign language. Now to become a fast learner, there are some facts that we can go through. Now FAST, F-A-S-T, what does it stand for? F stands for focused. A stands for active learner. S stands for state of mind. T stands for teach. Let me just explain you this. As F stands for focused, to be a focused person and to be a fast learner, you will have to forget three things. Now, what are the three things? Firstly, you'll have to forget that you know the subject very well. You'll have to learn and try to learn new things, new learnings in new prospective way. Secondly, you'll have to forget the things that are not urgent and important to you, because that will be the distractions and you won't be able to be a fast learner. So you have to be active learner and you will have to let go the things those are not important and urgent to you. And lastly, forget your limitations. One should not feel as I am a slow learner or I won't be able to complete this on time. Instead, one should be an active learner and think beyond the limitations as your memory is not fixed. The more you are active, the more you will learn. Third one is states, that is state of mind. Now here I would like to share information, whatever information you have about the subject, added with your emotions, gives a long-term memory. That means information added with emotions gives a long-term memory. To be a fast learner, take control of your mood and the body language. Study at your comfort level, might be by sitting or standing or whatever way you feel energized. And the last one, that is teach. To be a fast learner, one should have the teaching intention. When you teach someone, you get to learn it twice and more. So if you wish to be a fast learner, you'll have to focus these four things. That is, you have to be focused, active learner, state of mind, and teach. Now, these are the things. Do you think these are the only factors which can make you a fast learner? Of course not. There are many other things which will help you out to be a fast learner. So we'll go through that. Yes. Healthy eating habits. Along with good practice, healthy eating habits also helps you to be a fast learner. So we'll quickly go through some brain foods. There are brain foods which can help you to be a quick and fast learner. Avocado, which will help keeping your healthy blood flow. There are blueberries, which are also known as brain berries. Blueberries reduces the effect of brain aging conditions. Protects your brain from oxidative stress. Then there is broccoli, which is a remarkable source of fiber, rich in vitamin K, which is known to enhance cognitive function and improves your brain power. There are a few other healthy eating habits. Coconut oil. Medium fatty acid helps to burn body fats, which also helps to create keratins. Eggs, rich in vitamin E, which enhances memory improving. Green leafy vegetables, all green leafy vegetables, especially spinach, which is good source of vitamin E. Turmeric, improves brain's oxygen intake to take you alert and able to process information. Keeps your immune system healthy. There are many more things, but I'll end up with this. Walnuts, which are rich in vitamin E. Lots of magnesium, which improves your mood and does your brain. And yes, this is everybody likes, that is a dark chocolate. Improves your focus, concentration, and mood. Generally, the darker the chocolate, the purer and better your brain. And lastly is water. You'll have to intake proper amount of water daily basis. After this, I would like to inform you that learning is one part, teaching is another part. As I'm a French tutor, I would always love to teach. And being a part of this session, I would appreciate if at the end of the webinar, if you learn something and go from this webinar. So let's learn with fun some French words. As I'm a French expert, why do you learn French? French is all around us. Merci, merci, merci. That means thank you, thank you, thank you. It is why to learn French. French is used as a worldwide language. French is the most widely used language all over the globe. Foreign language makes you wealthier. That is, people who are bilingual can earn a higher salary than those who are unilingual. Unilingual means a person who knows only one language, and bilingual means a person who knows more than one language. Foreign language helps you to increase your English vocabulary. Let's see what are the importance of learning French. Speaking French is important for global business. Bilingualism makes you smarter. Career with French, higher studies in France, international diplomacy, travel and tourism, work around the globe. Multilingual people are always in demand. Let's start the basics. I would like to request you all, as I'll learn something in French, you please repeat after me. India, in French, we say as La Onde. La Onde. India, La Onde. Second one is Paris. In French, we say Paris. Paris, Paris. Bon, good. Bon, good. Jour, day. It is not jour, it is jour. Jour, day. Salut. Salut means hello in informal way. Salut. Bonjour. Bonjour. Good morning. Hello. Bon après-midi. Bon means good. Après means after. And midi means half. So bon après-midi means good afternoon. Bonsoir. Bon means good. Soir means evening. Good evening. Bonsoir. Bon nuit. Bon means good. Nuit means night. Good night. I'll again repeat. La onde, Paris, bon, jour, salut, bonjour, bon après-midi, bonsoir, bon nuit. Now we'll go to the introduction part. How to introduce yourself? The first one says, Je m'appelle Nikita. Je m'appelle Nikita. I call myself Nikita. Je m'appelle Nikita. Como ça va? In English, we say comment, but in French, it is como. Como ça va? Como ça va? How are you? That is an informal way. Ça va, I am fine. Ça va, I am fine. That is an informal way. Comment allez-vous? Comment allez-vous? How are you? That is an informal way. Comment allez-vous? Comment allez-vous? How are you? Informal way. We write here vous. Vous is written when you speak to the elders. So it is como allez-vous? Je vais bien. I am fine. Je vais bien. I am fine. I hope you all are repeating. I'm going very slow in this. Je vais bien. I am fine. Êtes-vous? Et means and. Vous means you. Êtes-vous? Je vais bien, merci. Je vais bien, merci. I am fine, thank you. Merci, thank you. Now we'll go to the introduction part. How you will introduce yourself? Je suis de la onde. Êtes-vous? Je suis de la onde. Êtes-vous? If you are talking to your elders, then it should be mentioned as vous. If you are talking to your friends, you can mention as toi. Je suis de la Inde et vous? I am from India and you? Je suis de Paris. Je suis de Paris. I am from Paris. Je suis de Paris. Enchanté. Enchanté means nice or pleased to meet you. Enchanté. Merci. Thank you. Merci. Thank you. Au revoir. Au revoir. Goodbye. Au revoir. Goodbye. Au revoir. Goodbye. Great. I think so. Now we should go to the video clip. Whatever you have learned, the same thing you can learn through a video as well. So, Enchanté ma'am, I request you to start with this video.
Writing's not that easy, but Grammarly can help. But it's wordy and hard to read.
The best way to learn a language like French is to go and live in the country where the language is spoken. Another great way to learn is by watching movies in that language. In this lesson, I transcribe basic French phrases from different movie clips and interview clips, and I will use them to help you start to learn the language. Let's start with the alphabet. Note that the ZH sound that you will encounter in the quotes below is pronounced Zh. It's the same sound you hear at the end of the words beige and garage. Repeat after me. A. B. C. D. E. F. G. H. I. J. K. L. M. N. O. P. Q. R. S. T. U. V. W. X. Y. Z. Watch this woman recite the 14 most frequently used letters in the French language. She's doing this for a patient who is 99% paralyzed and is only able to blink when he hears the letter he wants to use in a sentence.
E S A R I N T U L O M T P C C. Merci. Merci.
Here, highlighted in blue are some letters that I found a little tricky when I started studying French, because it's easy to confuse one letter for another in certain cases. Take E and I, for instance. Let's hear the same actress read out the letters so you can distinguish the difference for yourself.
E, S, A, R, I.
Now let's hear her pronounce U and O.
U, L, O.
And now G and J.
G, J.
G.
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 That leaves us with the letter R. In English, R comes from the front of your mouth, r, r, but in French, it comes from the back of your mouth, r, r. The French R is very tough for people who grew up speaking English. It's similar to the sound you make in your throat when you gargle mouthwash, and that's actually one way to practice pronouncing it. Let's listen to her pronounce the letter R.
R. R.
Now that we've worked on the alphabet, let's learn some salutations in French. I'm not going to go over every single one, just the most common and useful ones. There are three stages in the most basic interaction you'll find yourself in: a greeting, some sort of engaging question, and a farewell. Let's start off with the greeting stage.
Bonjour.
Bonjour.
Bonsoir.
Bonsoir.
Salut.
Ça
va? Très bien.
So, bonjour is hello, bonsoir is good evening, and salut is hi. Now let's ask some questions. You can ignore any words that I haven't highlighted in green.
Ariel, comment ça va?
Bien. Et toi?
Bah écoute, super.
Comment ça va and ça va are the same thing. Let's look at two clips that contain ça va. The first example will show you how to respond to ça va politely, and the other shows you how to respond to it in a rude way. Polite.
Ça va?
Ça va très bien, merci.
And rude.
Ça va?
Ça va.
Ça s'est bien passé au bureau aujourd'hui?
Glace.
If someone asks you how your day at work went, it's not polite to ignore the question and order them to bring you ice. Comment allez-vous? Is not as common as ça va, but it's good to know, in case you run into someone like this guy, who looks like he's been electrocuted.
Bonjour, Mademoiselle Bello. Comment allez-vous?
Je vais bien, merci. Et vous-même, vous allez bien?
Comment vas-tu? Is an informal version of comment allez-vous. They mean the same thing. Tu vas bien? Is a very common greeting question. It literally means, you are going well, but the English translation is, you're doing well?
Tu vas bien?
Bien et toi?
Comment vous appelez-vous is a polite way of saying, what's your name. Comment t'appelles-tu is an informal way of saying, what's your name. If someone asks you, comment t'appelles-tu, you'll respond by saying, je m'appelle, and then your name.
Je m'appelle Gabriel.
Moi, Emily.
And finally, here are some ways to bid people farewell. Au revoir means goodbye. Native French speakers tend to say it quickly, so you most likely won't hear it pronounced au revoir. The E would be removed, so if you heard it in France, it would sound like au revoir, but faster. Listen to these two women pronounce it.
Au revoir.
Au revoir.
One more time.
Au revoir.
Au revoir.
Bonne journée.
Bonne journée. À ce soir.
A bientôt means see you soon. Let's watch someone use it in a charming way, and then let's watch someone use it in a creepy way. Charming.
A bientôt.
A bientôt.
Creepy.
A très bientôt.
A très bientôt just means see you very soon. À demain.
Bonsoir, à demain, excusez-moi.
That was pretty fast. Watch it again and listen once more for the à demain.
Bonsoir, à demain, excusez-moi.
Bonne nuit.
Bonne nuit, Michel.
Bonne nuit, Céline.
That concludes this lesson. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to keep track of future videos.
Yeah.
Grammarly does more than catch error.
I hope you all have enjoyed viewing this video. Let's go ahead with the next slide. How to learn French. Yeah, learning French, you'll have to active your passive memory. That is by learning and by reading. You'll have to keep learning and listening to the music. You can also, go on listening to the French music, reading books. Great creativity to memorize gender. In French, we have genders, mostly male and female. In most of the verbs are categorized in male, masculine and feminine verbs. And the feminine verbs end with E. So it is easy. You'll have to memorize that genders in a creative way. Focus on intonation. Like they say bonjour, etwa, merci. So that all are the intonations. You'll have to focus on the intonation. More, you can watch news channels, French series with subtitles that will help you out for getting a good intonations. Beware of loan words. Loan words means, for example, in French, we say, oh la la. Oh la la means, oh gosh, okay. So here, we as an Indian, if we speak oh la la, it looks good. But if we go to France or if we go to foreign language, they don't appreciate much this loan words. So we, while learning foreign language, we should understand which words, where to use, when to use. And while learning a foreign language, don't be afraid to make mistakes, as we all learn from our mistakes, and we have to be focused on whatever we are learning. Not only with the foreign language, when we start learning anything in life, always remember one thing. That if plan A doesn't work, the alphabet has 25 more letters. That means whenever you start learning a foreign language or you start with anything new in your life, you'll be definitely having some strategies. But if that strategy doesn't work out, you don't have to get demotivated. Instead, you should go ahead with other plans and other strategies. I'll share some few apps which are the best for learning languages. First one is Babbel. Best for an online school type experience. You can go through these apps. This will be helpful. Second one is Mondlin. That is best for helping you remember phrases. Third one is Duolingo. That is best for learning multiple languages. Memorize. Best for learning to speak casually in a new language. And the last one is Busuu, that is best for goal-oriented users. So these are some apps which can help you out to learn new languages, foreign languages. Okay, now just to make this session more interactive. See, as I told you, as you all have invested your time, I want at least you should take something after this webinar. So quickly go through these words. And if you remember 2-3 words also, this session will be beneficial. Let's go quickly go through these words and remind. Keep them in remind. India, La Onde. Paris, Paris. Bon, good. Jour, day. Salut. Hello in informal way. Bonjour, good morning or hello. Bon après-midi, that is good afternoon. Bonsoir, good evening. Bonne nuit, good night. I'll give you a few seconds, just go through again. Because we are going to start a self-assessment, you can take a pen and paper and do a self-assessment whether you remember or not. And if you don't, doesn't matter, because nobody can become a foreign language expert within 30-40 minutes. We all can understand, but this just an interactive session. Yes, these are the words. Write it on your paper. India, Paris, good morning, good evening, and thank you. These are the 5 words. Please write. Translate them in French. Ansita ma'am, please start the music. Pancetta ma'am, please let me know the answers.
Ma'am, you can check that in a chat box YouTube in their writing.
Okay.
Yeah, they are sharing their answers in YouTube channel. Most of them are answering right now.
I'm sorry?
Most of them are answering. The perfect answer they are giving.
Yeah, so on the next slide, there are the answers. Okay, in French, answers we say as réponses. Réponses, first one was India, Le Onde, Paris, Paris. Good morning, bonjour. Good evening, bonsoir, and thank you, merci. I hope you would all have done a self-assessment. How you will rate yourself, viewers? So I would like to give you the parameters. Anshita ma'am, please. Let's learn with fun assessment parameters. Those who have scored 5 on 5 will give themselves bravo. That is well done. 4 on 5, they can give themselves as très bon. That is very good. 3 on 5, bon, good. And the people, those who have scored below 3, they don't have to afraid to make mistakes. Try and try till you succeed. This was just an interaction session. I'm sure you would all have understood and enjoyed this session. Congratulations to all of you, those who attempted this. Félicitations. In French, we say as a félicitations. Félicitations. Congratulations to one and all. My online crash course for learning French will be starting soon. Those are interested can contact me on my mobile number and email ID as well. Thank you. Merci. Have a great evening. Take care of yourself.
Over to Jinal, ma'am.
Thank you so much, Nikita, ma'am, for your wonderful presentation. Dear audience, very soon we will start with the question answer session. Please put your questions on the chat. Over to Jinal, ma'am.
Thank you, Nikita, ma'am, for such an interesting and interactive session. So there are a few questions that our viewers have asked. So very first one is, as you said, that foreign languages helps one to focus more. So how does it help in focusing?
Focus more means you will become, your memory sharpens up, right? And focusing doesn't mean, focusing means you have to forget 3 things that I have already explained, that you have to forget the things which are not urgent and important. So in that way, your focus in span increases. And other things are also there, like focusing in the sense you have to keep, you have to be an active learner. Every day you have to make a ritual that you will be learning, reading and going through French or whatever foreign language you opted for. So once you are focused, if you have that goal that you have to start learning, see, when you start anything new, it is always hard. In the middle, it's messy. And at the end, it's gorgeous. So we have to go till the end, right? So when you can go till the end, when you're focused for that thing.
So in that thing, you can go ahead with the new languages.
Okay, ma'am, the next question is, someone has asked, is online learning a good platform for learning new languages, or should we go for the traditional classroom method?
See, as of now, during this pandemic, yes, online learning is only going on. And yes, of course, there are, you have to go with the classes as well. Right now, during this pandemic, you should go ahead for online learning. And in future, when everything opens up, everything is normal, at that time, we can guide you from where you can take exams and all. French, you can learn from Alliance Francais. And there are basic levels are there, A1, A2, B1, B2, C1, C2. If you learn from anyone, from anywhere, at last you will have to give exams from Alliance Francais, that is a French embassy. So accordingly, the teacher will guide from where to go, how to pay, what to do, how to give the exams and all.
One question is, in French, we do not use capital letters.
I'm sorry, your voice is not audible.
In French, we do not use capital letters in the middle of the sentence. Is there any change in this rule?
Can you please repeat?
So someone has asked, in French, we do not use capital letters in the middle of the sentence. Is there any change in the rule for countries?
No, there's no change in the rule. It is same as English. We have to start with the capital letter. And it, the name of a person that can be used in capital, otherwise it's same as English only.
Okay. One question is, why do we use L in front of India when you said India?
Yeah, that is a great question. See, before any verb or before any noun, you add article. Article, that is the. The means in French, it is le, L-E, le. L-A la, L-E-S le. So la is used in front of feminine verbs. La is used in front of masculine and le is used in front of the plural one. Now India in French, it is ond, I-N-D-E. E ends, India and, ond ends with E. So that is a feminine word. So feminine word, the article will be la, L-A. Now, la, that is a grammar. It is an in-depth study. Like L-A, A and India starts with I. So A and I, both are vowels. When this both clash, A has to eliminate and an apostrophe comes. So in that way, the article has been used.
Okay, ma'am. Last one and the most frequently asked question this is, which is the easiest way or are there any tricks to learn foreign languages to remember them better?
Yes, you can go through many tricks, apps, which I also go through. Like there are 3 minutes, you can go through 3 minutes daily learning. You can go through apps which helps you to learn foreign language. There are apps, 3 minutes, every day 3 minutes you learn one word. So that in that ways only you can learn quickly and faster, because every day, otherwise if you see one level, A1 takes 3 months, A2 takes 3 months. So in that ways, if you don't have time, you can go through different apps that can give you this quick learning process, tricks, everything will be given in that apps. And usually, if you want to learn anything, you have to be active. You have to be ritual in that. Every day you will have to stick with that thing. You will have to do all you will have to go through all the lessons properly, everything. Then it is easy.
Okay. Thank you so much, Nikita ma'am. Now I will pass on to Preeti ma'am. Over to you, Preeti ma'am.
Good evening, one and all. It gives me immense pleasure to extend a very hearty vote of thanks on behalf of Bansanga Aarti Shashi Kiran Shetty Junior College to our guest speaker for the day, Mrs. Nikita Ganantra ma'am, for having graciously consented to participate in today's webinar. and sharing her views. I express my deepest gratitude to ma'am for enlightening and enriching us on importance of learning foreign languages. Thank you very much, ma'am. We are indeed greatly honored by your presence. I would like to express my sincere thanks to N. Vivek Shetty, Chairman, Higher Education Committee, Shri Kishore Kumar Kuttiyar, Vice Chairman, Higher Education Committee, Shrimati Mamta Shetty, Vice Chairperson, Higher Education Committee, Shri Bhaskar Shetty Karnad, Secretary, Higher Education Committee, C.A. Ramesh Shetty, Treasurer, Higher Education Committee, for providing their continuous support and motivation. I convey my heartfelt gratitude to our Vice Principal, Shrimati Shaila Shetty, for sharing her expertise and able guidance. I would like to extend my thanks to the organizing team, all my fellow teachers and support staff for their enormous cooperation and making this event memorable one. A special word of praise and thanks to a technical team. Without you, this webinar would have not been possible. Finally, the profound participants who have turned up in such a great numbers, not only from our college, but from various other colleges as well. Thank you so much for your cooperation and for being part of our webinar. Hope to see you all in further. Hope to see you all in further such events. Once again, thank you all. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah.